Hi friends, today we are going to solve problems on nozzle velocity. See here, problem 1, dry saturated steam at 5 bar with negligible velocity expands isentropically in a convergent nozzle to 1 bar and dryness fraction 0.94. Determine the velocity of steam leaving the nozzle. So nozzle నుంచి బయటికి వెళ్ళేటప్పటికి ఎంత వెలాసిటీ ఉంటుంది అనేది కనుక్కోమన్నారు. మనకి డ్రైనెస్ ఫ్రాక్షన్ 0.94 ఇచ్చారు. ప్రెషర్ వచ్చేసరికి 5 బార్ ఇచ్చారు. ఓకే, నౌ లెట్స్ సీ హౌ టు సాల్వ్ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లం. ప్రాబ్లం 1. నౌ solution given. So what is the given data in here? Pressure P1 5 bar, again P2 1 bar, and dryness fraction X2 is equal to 0.94 is given. Okay, so now we are going to steam tables. So from steam tables, corresponding to a pressure of 5 bar, okay, corresponding to a pressure of 5 bar, we find that enthalpy or total heat of dry saturated steam. Enthalpy or total heat of dry saturated steam, that is equal to 2747.5 kilojoules per kg, and corresponding to a pressure of 1 bar, corresponding to a pressure of 1 bar, we find that now this is pressure of 5 bar, then here I can write 1 bar, pressure of 1 bar. From steam tables we get these values, and HF GT, G2 is equal to kilojoules per kg. Therefore, enthalpy or total heat of final steam, total heat of final steam, that's one, H2 is equal to HF2 plus X2 into GF2. This equation we know very well. In previous Rankine cycle, you can find so many problems like this. So we can find out, substitute the values in here. Okay, calculate this, we will get the answer 2 value, and enthalpy or heat drop, that is called HD, is equal to H1 minus H2. Then H1 is equal to, we know very well, then H2 is equal to, so calculate this, we'll get the answer in here, kilojoules per kg. So now this is called HD. Okay, now we know that velocity of steam leaving the nozzle, that velocity of steam leaving the nozzle V2 is equal to 44.72 √HD. Then we substitute the values in here. Calculate this, you will get the final velocity of the nozzle with meter per second square. Then here I can note this kinetic energy is equal to ½mv². Then half into m into, now here we take m is equal to 1, the velocity v2. You can write here v² / 2 joules, that is equal to 1/1000 of v² / 2 kilojoules, since m is equal to 1 kg. Okay, this is the procedure to solve the problem to find the final velocity of the steam nozzle. And then we go for another problem in here. Dry saturated steam at a pressure of 15 bar enters in a nozzle. Pressure 15 bar, okay, enters in a nozzle and discharged at a pressure of 1.5 bar. Alage discharged pressure vachesi P2 vachesariki 1.5 bar. Find the final velocity of the steam. So here also we are going to find V2. When the initial velocity of the steam is negligible, okay, initial velocity V1 is equal to 0. If 10% of heat drop is lost in friction, friction valla manaki 10% heat anedi loss avutha undi. So find the percentage reduction in the final velocity. Final ga velocity vachesariki enta percentage of heat reduction avutundanedi ippudu manam kanukkovali. Okay, so then we go for here problem number 2. Solution, okay, now given, and given here inlet pressure is 15 bar, and then outlet pressure is 1.5 bar. Okay, then final velocity of steam. So V2 we need to find out in here. Okay, from steam tables, similarly previous, what can we did? We can do as usual. From steam tables, corresponding to a pressure of 15 bar, we find that enthalpy of dry saturated steam H1 is equal to 1, and corresponding to here pressure 1, 15 bar, and then corresponding outlet pressure P2, 1.5 bar, okay, enthalpy of dry saturated steam. Now we go for directly, you can take here 2693.4 kilojoules per kg. So therefore heat drop HD is equal to H1 minus H2. Then H1 is equal to, and now H2 is equal to, you can substitute that values H1 and H2. Okay. Now calculate this, we will get the answer here with meter per second square. This is for, this 96.5, this is heat drop, no? Okay, kilojoules per kg. Okay, so now we are going to find velocity at nozzle V2 exist. Okay, so now here 44.72 root of HD. Then substitute the value in here. Then calculate this, you will get the answer with meter per second square. But in here, in this problem said percentage reduction, percentage reduction in the final velocity. We need to find out percentage reduction in the final velocity. So now we know that heat drop lost in friction is equal to 10%, that is equal to 0.1. So therefore nozzle coefficient or nozzle efficiency, then K is equal to 1 minus 0.1, that is equal to 0.9. So we know that final velocity V2 is equal to, with the help of nozzle, now the constant term here, K into HD. Okay, then substitute these values in here. Okay. Now write down 44.72 root of 0.9 into, what is the HD? 96.5. Then calculate this, 416.8 meter per second. Okay. So therefore, percentage reduction in final velocity V2, that is equal to 439.3 minus 416.8, and I mean this velocity and this velocity, we will get the average of this. So finally we will get the percentage of loss in 5.1%. This is the answer. Okay. This is the procedure to solve the problem. And now we go for another problem in here. Problem number 3. Dry saturated steam at 10 bar is expanded isentropically. Dry saturated steam at 10 bar is expanded isentropically in a nozzle in 0.1 bar. Okay, one is 10 bar and another one is 0.1 bar. Using steam only, find the dryness fraction of the steam at exist. V2 you need to find out here. And now here go to dryness fraction, not to V2, x value. Dryness fraction is called x. So also find the velocity of steam, and also we can find out here leaving the nozzle, means here V2, when one inlet initial velocity is negligible and initial velocity of steam is 1.135 meter per second. Okasaremo ఇనిషియల్ వెలాసిటీ అనేది 0 తీసుకోమని చేయమన్నారు, ఇంకోసారేమో ఇనిషియల్ వెలాసిటీ టేక్ 135 మీటర్ పర్ సెకండ్స్. ఓకే, సో రెండు రకాలకు ఇప్పుడు మనం ఇక్కడ కనుక్కోవాల్సి వస్తుంది. సో ఓకే, హౌ యూ విల్ ఫైండ్, లెట్ అస్ సీ. సో నౌ ప్రాబ్లం నెంబర్ 3. Now solution, given. Now I can write given data from problem. So now here P1 is equal to 10 bar and P2 is equal to 0.1 bar. So now here we need to find out dryness fraction at exist. X is equal to dryness fraction of the steam at exist. So now X2. Then, okay, you can write down here from steam tables. From steam tables at pressure P1 is equal to 10 bar. Okay, we find entropy. So entropy is coming from S is equal to SG1. Now here you take only entropy, okay. This is entropy. H means enthalpy, S means entropy. Okay, in first chapter we'll solve the problems like that. And corresponding to a pressure of 0.1 bar, we find entropy SFG is equal to 0.649 kilojoules per kg kelvins, and SFG2 is equal to 7.502 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Okay, then we write down here dryness fraction equation. Since the expansion of steam is isentropic, therefore entropy of steam at inlet S1 is equal to S2. That is called entropy of steam at exist S2. This is inlet and this is exist. So now here we write down here S1 is equal to, the S2 is SF2, okay, plus X and plus SFG2. Now here this is G. Now substitute this value in here. Dryness fraction we don't know, so then here we put X2 because of this is for outlet. Then X2 is equal to, solve this equation, we can find X2. This is the X2 value. Okay, one term is over. And now next we are going for steam leaving the nozzle with the initial velocity is 0. So then we are going to find out here V2. So before going to V2, V2 is how much? Okay, initial velocity is 0, then V exist velocity is how much? So before we are going to solve the V2, from steam tables, corresponding to a pressure at 10 bar P1, we find the enthalpy or total heat dry saturated steam. Okay, then you can take these values from steam tables, kilojoules per kg, and now go for corresponding the pressure at 0.1 bar. We take here HF2 is equal to 191.8 kg and HFG is equal to 2. This is HFG you can take. Okay, and now this is HFG2. Then here you can write down 2392.9 kilojoules per kg. So therefore enthalpy drop HD is equal to enthalpy or total heat of steam exist. Now total heat of steam exist we need to find. Before going that we need to find total enthalpy. Okay, HT, H2, steam exists, H2. So HFG plus X plus HFG2, not plus, not 2. And similarly, we can substitute these values in here. X already we find. And into 2392.9. So solve this equation, we get exist enthalpy kilojoules per kg. Okay, and now we go for heat drop. Now we go for heat drop. Here HD is equal to you know very well H1 minus H2. Then H1 is equal to 2776.2 minus 2084.6. Now calculate this, so you'll get the answer kilojoules per kg. Look at here H1 value I substitute, at the same time H2 value we find, this one also substitute, and then we'll get HD. So we know very well about velocity at the nozzle exist, V2 is equal to HD. Then six meter per second. This is the answer. Okay, but this is initial velocity is zero. You take initial velocity is zero, but now we are going to solve velocity of steam leaving the nozzle when initial velocity V1 is equal to 135 meter per second. This is given. Initial velocity is zero, then V2 is equal to, this is the value. Now here V1 is equal to 135 meter per second, then V2 is equal to how much? This is the another question. Okay, this is coming from second point. We need to find out. This is first point we need to find here. Okay, now we know that velocity of steam leaving the nozzle V2 is equal to, with relation of initial velocity V1 square plus 2000 HD. Okay, now substitute this value, simply you'll get the answer 135 whole square plus 2000 into HD already we find. Okay, now calculate this, we'll get the answer 1184 meter per seconds. This is the answer. Look at this. Okay, now the velocity will increase here automatically. V2 final velocity will also increase. Now here in velocity is zero, the final velocity it will come 1176. Here little bit will increase velocity outlet. Okay, so this is the procedure to solve the problems in velocities. And now next class we are going to solve the problems on yes, mass of steam discharged through nozzles. Okay, so mass of steam discharged through nozzles, we need to find out next class. Okay, thank you.